here with Rosemary Watkins from Family Therapy Consultancy. Thank you for joining me today. I've got a few questions from the public that they've sent in for me, if you don't mind. I'm going to read this out. So we've got a question. My children live in Canada and I cannot bear to throw their things out and they don't want them. Old scouts uniform, old Girl Guides uniforms, etc. My question is this because I still see them as little children? They were between 10 and 12 when they had these uniforms and now they're 40 and 42 respectively, or because I miss them terribly and these are the last things I have of them that are permanent?
Gosh, yeah, you can almost hear the sort of touching and desire for that, having them a bit closer. But obviously without knowing the fullness of the story, I wouldn't be able to, the situation, the total detail of what might be happening. But for many people, they do tend to keep something from the childhood, from the children's past. And it's not, that doesn't necessarily mean there's any problem with that. Like, it would depend on the amount of it and the space and energy that it's taking in the home, and whether how often or how frequent that she might be looking at it or contacting, making connection with it. That might suggest that there's something there that might be, you know, could benefit from being looked at emotionally. In terms of the distance between them and the connection to them as little children, and now as adults, you know, there may be something there in that, but it would depend on, if she was looking at them every day or something like that. If she just simply has them in a cupboard somewhere that she likes them and it's a small amount in a small box, many people keep one or two items like that. Whether the Girl Guide uniform or the Scouts does it for her, or there's other things that she has. It's like a little memory box in a way, that people, a memento box that people can put some things into. And it can be quite meaningful and touching to see, or even show them from time to time. But certainly I think the volume, the frequency, all of that would need to be known to know for sure whether there's a maybe something she could do with benefit from looking at in the emotional side of the clutter that happens with holding on to items.
Thank you. We often suggest to clients, if they have a maximum, so if they have a container, and then when it's full, you know, they think about whether or not they want to keep everything. And another strategy is to take photos, but I suppose a lot of people like to feel the item in their hands. A photo doesn't work. Do you find that?
That's you know, can happen for some people, particularly if there's an attachment to the article where they have memories very strongly attached to it. And again, I think the volume is probably the main thing here. If they keep one small 10-year-old's Girl Guide uniform, and that's not taking up much space, and it's something that's just a nice memory to have and connection, then it's probably fine. But I like your idea there of maybe giving them a box to, and then take photos. If that works for some people, it's a great way to kind of still have the memory of that and not the actual volume of items in the home.
All right, thank you.